basically.
Actually, I will tell you a little bit about our elephant. Actually, we are a pretty big elephant as such, and I would like to start telling you the story about our banking group, because possibly not everybody is familiar with us and also with the programs that we had in the past. So this is what I would like to start with. I would like to give you also a very good insight why we actually started this whole investment, because it is an investment, and the why, as it is here, is for us actually always in the core of everything that we are actually doing. Yeah? So that's the start of everything we are doing. Why are we doing that, and which customer problem are we actually solving? And you might say, okay, that's normal, but I would say for a bank that's not always normal to put the why from a customer perspective at the very beginning, and this is something that changed. Coming back, telling you something about the Erste Group. The Erste Group is currently operating, as Stefan said, in 7 markets across Central Eastern Europe, having the headquarters in Vienna, serving about 17 million customers. And the thing is, in the meantime, 60% of those customers don't come to the branches anymore. But still, we have about 3,000 branches out there across the whole region. And this is something that will change, at least in terms of the format of the branches and the functions of the branches out there, because we simply have understood that the customer behavior has significantly changed in the recent years. And another thing that we have currently about 46,000 people out there, and out of those 46,000 people, more than 6,000 people are just in IT. So the IT we have is a pretty huge animal, actually, and I will come to that later, actually, what this has to do with the story of BeeOne. At the moment, we have a very good market position, still, in those 7 countries, we are, for retail, for private customers, still the number one in 4 markets, but we need to understand that some of those banks that we acquired in the last 10 years, we started with a market share of 95% in the early 2000s. Because those were state-owned banks, for example, in Czech Republic, and those market shares have actually shrinked in the last 10 years, for example, in Czech Republic to about 40%. And obviously, we have a problem there. And one of the problems that we have is with the change in the society. And for a long time, people in our banking group, and for sure also in other banking groups, thought, well, digital banking is something on top of the traditional banking, it's something you must have, but you don't need to be very good at it, actually. And it's actually always just for a kind of niche target group. Yeah? What we see here is, in the last couple of years, is that the society is tremendously changing, and that possibly the most conservative target group that you can ever imagine is using tablets and smartphones like hell. And we also see it with our customer base. In the meantime, it's not just the 19 to 25-year-old people that are using mobile payments and tablet banking. It's actually everybody, also people beyond 60 are heavily using our applications, in particular on tablets. And this has changed. But the problem is, very often we are not there on those devices, yeah? Or are not in the way that the customers might expect us to be. And another problem that we actually have is that, especially in the last years, investments in our industry have gone somewhere else. And it's not just about the investments in terms of innovation in financial services. It's also about creativity, and it's mainly about time to market, it's about speed. And banks are traditionally not very fast in developing new services. And this is why those guys, and in particular also the big ones like PayPal, they're actually carving out parts of our value chain throughout the time. And this is a big threat for us. And we in Erste Group, when we speak about competition, we do not regard other banks like UniCredit as the typical competitors anymore. We rather see those guys or PayPal or Visa and MasterCard rather as our competition for the future. And yes, you might say, okay, banks have tried to be mobile. Yeah? Yes, we have tried to go mobile already in 2010, but this is how it looked like, or at least how it felt like in the early days. Yeah? And at a certain point of time, our CEO, Mr. Treichel, actually came to a point where we said, well, we have a problem. We are losing market shares. We are not fast enough. And then he actually gave us the mandate, okay, think about it. What can we do, also from an organizational point of view, to make a change in this company across the region? And our starting point in 2011 was as such. Actually, we had no innovation strategy. We had a leakage in the customer base. We had a very limited and pretty old-fashioned digital offer with a limited range of mobile services. And actually, real innovation, apart from traditional product development, that was really just a hobby. At the beginning, it was me and two guys, also from other departments, that have started a group-wide crowdsourcing and innovation contest. And that was just a kind of experiment in 2011. But it was quite successful. And that also then gained the appetite of our CEO. And finally, I was sent for the winter 2011 to 2012 to Barcelona to our cooperation bank, which is Caixa Bank, the biggest Spaniard bank, and also a very innovative bank. And those guys actually have already seen a lot of trends. About 10 years ago, they had founded an incubator and an innovation lab already 10 years ago. And I had the chance to feel there how innovation can work and look like in banking. But unfortunately, when I came there, this is how I felt when I compared our banking group to this banking group there. Yeah? Because we had not much in place, and those guys, they really got the job done already for about 10 years' time. So then it was about the how. When I came back, our CEO asked me and also two other guys, could we build this up for us? Because Spain, it's also not easy, it's a huge market, but it's just one market. In our case, it's seven markets. And it's also not quite easy because traditionally we have a very decentralized governance model. So that's also somewhat the downside of our model. And so we presented him a concept that basically had two pillars. The one pillar was the so-called Erste Hub. The Erste Hub is a project. It's a project, an interdisciplinary project that encompasses IT, business, marketing. And BeeOne was founded as a dedicated unit, as a subsidiary of the holding. And in this constellation, we were founded to do basically two things. The first one, to really face the challenges that are ahead of us, and secondly, to create customer experiences that are really relevant, that are really solving problems of our customers out there. And part of that, of course, is also to question your own business model. This is what we also are doing, and as you can imagine, that's not always a very easy job. And finally, to do that, to succeed, we have been given, or actually we gave ourselves, some principles about our work. The first, and for me, the most important thing is about the team, that we really find and actually found a very unique skill of people, not just typical bankers, but a mix of bankers with people from other industries. That was, for me, the most decisive part of the whole setup phase in 2012. The second is that we have a very clear support mandate from the very top to make things happening. I've just talked today with colleagues also in Germany, with German savings banks as well. And I mean, if you imagine that you have a couple of thousand people out there in the branches and they see the online channel somewhat as a threat, then you can imagine how big the mandate and the support from the very top must be in order that you can actually make a change. Yeah? So that's extremely important for us. also a funding that you get a certain autonomy and that you have a certain seed money that you can experiment the processes in place, because certainly real innovation does not come by coincidence. So you need to have a certain very stringent process in place. And finally, with our governance model, what we say is we do not want to push anybody to cooperate with us. We first want to work, we want to create some stuff, and then the pool will come. And that was also as it actually worked out. So we started with just two of the banks, and in the meantime also the other banks were knocking on our door and asking us to cooperate. That was by far more successful as we would have gone for any kind of push. Speaking about the team, we are about 25 people big. Those are the pictures from the early days. And the team, as said, is about 50% bankers, as I am, and 50% coming from other industries, meaning other labs, startups, completely other industries, like the gaming industries. The second part of the mix is that we have many different cultures and nations actually in there. And the third dimension is actually that we do not only have people that are doing research, but we also have people that are developing. So we have our own coding team, for example. We have 10 developers in there with whom we can prototype. That's extremely important. Yeah? Because if you have an armada of about 5,000 people in your corporate IT, and they are basically having the monopole to tell you what's possible in the IT and what's not possible, those 10 guys are extremely important. Yeah? And with at least 10 guys, you can already break up a lot of things, because you can question the first time things which the corporate IT is actually telling you that works or works not. So what we build is, we build a very high competition. We build a very high competition among our team, but we also build it in a way that there's a very high competition between us and the corporate units of the bank, in particular also the IT. The throughputs that we had in those first 15 months looks like that we have been working around almost 70 ideas that we have either we ourselves created or our cooperating partners, our banks. And at the moment we have already 8 projects implemented, so real applications being available in the market. Some other stuff we are currently launching, and some other stuff we are still prototyping. But the thing is, for this team, for those people that came here, those people were not searching for any kind of secure job that they would typically expect in a bank. Those guys and ladies, they just came for the challenge. And I guess it's a big challenge actually in a very traditional environment as a bank is to really try to change the whole way of working of this bank. That's basically our agenda.